Okay, students, we have third part. Left hand side is A union B intersection C. All right. So A set is plus minus multiply union B intersection C. B, you will write B set and then C set. Okay. Now you will find the intersection of these two sets. All right. Now, what are the common symbols? Subtraction. You can see that. And division. All right. So we will write it like this. Okay, now we will take union. We have addition, subtraction, multiplication, and second set is subtraction and division. And you know that for union, we will write all the elements all together. So we will write it like this, plus, minus, multiply, and division. All right, we are done with it. Okay, now we have right hand side. A union B intersection A union C. All right, so you have two brackets basically. First, you will find A union B, that is plus, minus, multiply, division. And then you will find A union C, that is plus, minus, division, multiply, and square root. You will write all the elements all together. All right. Next step is you will find the intersection of these two sets. All right. We will write these sets, plus, minus, multiply, division, intersection, plus, minus, multiply, division, and square root. All right. So the answer is, what are the common elements? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So the answer is addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. This is right hand side and this is left hand side. You can see that they both are same. So we have proof that left hand side is equals to right hand side. Okay. Okay, class, basically, we have question. You will solve all these questions for this statement as well as for this statement. All right. I have done this part and this part for this statement. All right. You will do part 2, part 1, part 3 for this statement as well. All right. Okay. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, we have question number 3. Okay, question number 3 is, verify distributive law of intersection over union for the following sets. Verify distributive law of intersection over union for the following sets. X is empty set, Y is singleton, that is 0, and Z is set of natural numbers. Set of natural numbers that starts from 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to so on. So, come to the solution. First, we will write the given. X set is empty, Y is 0, and Z is set of natural numbers. So, 1, 2, 3, that means 1, 2, 3, up to so on. Alright? What we have to prove? We have to prove that X intersection Y union C, okay? Distributive law of intersection over union. Now you can see that we have X, Y, Z. Okay. There is no A, B, C. So we can change it. We will write X instead of A. We will write Y instead of B. We will write Z instead of C. Okay. Clear? All right. So we have to prove that X intersection Y union Z is equals to X intersection Y union X intersection Z. Alright. So first, left hand side is X intersection Y union Z. Okay, students. We will write X set, that is empty, intersection bracket Y set, that is 0, Z set, that is 1, 2, 3, up to so on. Because this is set of natural numbers. Okay. First, we will find Y union Z. Okay, you can see that we will write all the elements all together. So the answer will be 0, 1, 2, 3, up to so on. All right. Now we will find intersection. You can see that there is no common element. There is no common element. So the answer is empty set. Now come to the right hand side. X intersection Y, 0, X intersection Z. Okay. Now, X set is empty, intersection Y set is 0, union, x intersection, sorry, x set is empty, intersection, z set is 1, 2, 3, up to so on. Alright, so first we will find this bracket. As you can see that there is no common element. If there is no common element, then you will write empty set. And for this bracket, there is no common element, so we will write empty set. Now, when you will find the union for empty set, the answer will be empty set. Okay? If it is two sets and they both are empty sets, the answer will be empty set. Now, you can see that. Left-hand side is empty set, right-hand side is empty set. So, left-hand side is equals to right-hand side. We have proved that x intersection y union z is equals to x intersection y union x intersection z. Okay, question number two, question number one, part two, one, three, like one, two, three, you will solve it for this A intersection B union C and A intersection union A intersection C. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, students, take care and Allah Hafiz. Stay safe.